just to show you how it works, how the design series works. So I've got my blue for real here. So with these colours, it's good to give them a good mix. So because they're so heavily pigmented, you want to mix it all up just so that the colour comes out true to what it should be. So I'm going to just then I'm going to take my dotting tool, so my gel colour artist series dotting tool, which is really great. It has the big one on the end for the bigger spots and then the small one for the small dots. So I'm going to take the big one and get a little bit on the end, and I'm going to place a nice big circle by swirling the gel around just in the middle here of the design. And as you can see, the colour is super pigmented, like it's a great blue. You don't have to go on and do a second coat. I don't need to flash cure that now. I can just leave it because it really holds its shape, and that's what I really like about this. Like when I've been using other gels, I would put a line down, like an intricate line, and then it would just kind of spread out on the nail, and you'd be like, oh, like that's not what I put down in the first place, and you'd have to keep flash curing it, so it wastes time. So if I wanted to, like I could go in and kind of like make my circle a little bit nicer. So it's a nice circle there now. So I clean my brush, and then I'm going to take this really amazing orange, which is called Cantaloupe on a First Date. Good name. And so I'm just going to pick up a little bit with my striping brush by OPI. So this is part of the Gel Color Artist series brushes, and this is amazing for details and lines. So I just need to take a little bit out of the pot. You can use work directly from the pot, and I'm just going to go around my circle. So just follow it around. Notice I haven't flash cured it because I don't need to. It's just going to waste time. So I'm just going to brush on an outline, but leaving a gap of the white around the blue. It's such a strong pigmented colour. It's just amazing. So I don't have to keep going over and over it. I'm just placing it one stroke, just following the design. If you guys have any questions while I'm doing this, just feel free to fire them out. Any questions or something? So just spreading the colour around. I mean, it just acts like paint, really. It's just, it's not like the usual gel that's spread and ruined things for you.
Sophie, somebody said that you are awesome.
Aw, thank you.
And somebody asked, how can they get a job with OPI?
So. I guess work hard, be dedicated.
Work hard, be dedicated.
Practice.
Which brush are you using, Sophie?
So this is the striping brush from the artist series, the Gel Color Artist series. So it comes in a pack. We actually have a few. We have this really nice striper, which is great for detail. And then we have our dotting tool, which has a bigger end and a shorter and a smaller ends for little dots. And then we have kind of like blending brush, which you can make really great gradients with. And then we also have a tidy up brush, so any mistakes, you can just sweep them away because it's gel. So,
great.
When can you purchase the gels, and is it soakable?
They should be coming out in July, and yes, they're soak off just like our normal gel colour. It comes off really, really easily. It's not any more soaking time than usual, so 15-20 minutes, which is how long it takes to soak off the gel colour. It just comes straight off. No damage to the nail plate, and it's not harsh on the nail.
So, purchase in July, yes, they're soakable.
So, So I've just got my shapes. This is like a Turkish iron inspired design. You know, the kind of good luck symbol. And then here's like I've kind of messed up a little bit here. So I can just take my tiny art brush, dip it in a little NAS99, and I can actually just take it away where I want to go. It's the amazing thing about gel. Like, it's not like now lateral wear. It's permanent and you can't do anything about it. So I've removed that. And notice I haven't cured yet. Because this design, you're not putting colour on colour, I can just keep going with it. So I'll probably give that a little cure now in the lamp. It's just 30 seconds in the lamp. Okay, so take that out now. And then the great thing about these is that you can actually mix the colours to create whatever colour you want. So I've got this really nice teal colour and I just want to make it a bit brighter, a bit lighter. So I can just take it directly out of the pot. Mix a little, so just on a bit of the expert touch wraps, and then a little bit of the white. So I'm just mixing it to the colour that I want to get. So it gets really nice, light pastel blue, but it's still super vibrant, like it doesn't lose the kind of punchiness. And then at the side, I'm going to take my detail brush again. Pick up from this colour that I just mixed. So the possibilities are endless, really.
Sophie, how do you feel about the consistency compared to gel colour?
It's amazing. Like, it's not any different, really, like the consistency was. But the main point is that it's a lot firmer and it holds its shape so well. Like, if you're going to put down a line, it will sit there and it will stay there, unlike gel colour, which moves. And it becomes difficult, so I'm sorry, can't see it guys. So you can see it's not moving, it's not changing the shape, the colour's so pigmented that I'm not happy to go over it and over it. And take some more blue. And these brushes are amazing too, like this is definitely my favourite. You can create so many different looks with them. You get great detail, like very fine lines, like if I show you here, we have one here where I've created it.